Hey everybody, this is John. Today I'm going to show you how to test your car battery to see if it's defective and it needs to be replaced. So this morning when I got up, first time I used my truck in a week, turned the key, I noticed that it sort of turned over a little slow. Fine, got in, drove for like an hour, and then I got out, and then I started up a few times, and I noticed throughout the day it started to turn over. It would crank a little slower and a little slower. And then the second last time I got in, I said, dude, next time I turn that key, it's gonna click. Sure enough, got in, turned the key, click. I had to get a jump start. I drove an hour, got home, turned the key, and it started again. So this thing magically works again. So what's the deal? Okay, the alternator charged up the battery on the way home. Why was it dead in the first place? Because it probably has a bad cell. Let's take a look at the battery. So this is the car battery. It's got a positive terminal, a negative terminal. Now, you've got these little caps. What the hell is this? We're going to remove them. You have to be careful because inside there's acid. So, you're going to see there's 6 holes. This battery has 6 individual cells. When the battery is fully charged, each cell should be around 2.1 volts. And if the 6 of them are at 2.1 volts, add it up, you're going to get 12.6 volts across the two terminals. Now, the electrolyte in the battery is around 1/3 of sulfuric acid and 2/3 distilled water. So it's like, I don't know, it's like 36 and 64, whatever the math is. But the thing is, because there's acid in here, it has a density, and you can actually measure the density or the specific gravity of the acid. And if the battery is not charged up, or if one of the cells is not charged up, the density would be different than the other cells. How do you do it? Okay, well, this is a hydrometer. Hydrometer is just a thing that when you fill up the tube, this bobber floats. And on the bobber, you're gonna see there's lines here, and there's a thermometer in the bottom. So the thermometer is to correct, you know, if you're off the nominal temperature. So typically, what you'll see is if you're at 2.1 volts in a cell, the specific gravity is like 1.270. And if it's discharge, if it's, you know, if it's less than 2.1 volts, it's probably going to be, it will be less than 1.270. It'll be like 1.25 or even 1.1 something. Now, if the battery discharges, all the cells should be low. So these should all be the same. But if the battery is like fully charged, but you got one cell that's low, that's a defective battery. It means you got to get a new battery. So using the hydrometer, you can measure the density in each cell. I don't care about the absolute number, whether it's 1.27 or 1.26. What I want to see is if one of the cells is low. Stick the thing in, squeeze it, and fill up the thing with the acid water mix. And let it float a bit. And what I see here is on this particular one, it's in the good range. If I look at the number, the number on it's reading 1.270. So then you squeeze all the acid out of that one, measure the next one. So what this one shows is that the number is actually 1.100. It's almost fully sunk. That means that cell, the third cell, is like fully discharged. So after measuring all the cells, number one, I got 1270, two, 1270, three, I got 110, 100, four, I got 1260, 1265, and 1260. So what's the magic number? How do I know if I got a bad cell? Well, it's 0.020. So if you take your highest cell and the lowest cell, and then if the difference between them is more than 0.02, then the low one, that is your bad cell. Bad cell means the battery is defective and you have to get a new one. So for example, once I got this number here, 1270, if I got any cell that was below 1.250, that would mean that that was a bad defective cell and I'd have to get a new battery. So I'm just going to measure the battery voltage to see what I get. So we're getting 12.50 volts. Now we know 12.6 would be a fully charged battery. So we know we're 0.1 of a volt off. And I guess that bad cell
is only showing us maybe 2.0 volts instead of 2.1, and that's what's causing it to fall to 12.5 instead of being fully charged at 12.6, since all the other cells were pretty much fully charged.
So they had, even though I got home, was able to turn the key and the car started, I know that if I keep that battery, after a couple more times I try to start that car, it's probably going to break down on me, or I'll be in the desert somewhere and I'm going to be stranded. So that battery is getting replaced. Thanks for watching.